how to set autofocus on a DSLR. Let's talk a little bit in depth about this topic. Hello everybody, my name is Attila Mate from Blue Sky Photography, and today I'd like to talk to you about another topic which is very important in regards to your photography, and this is the autofocus. So if you want to improve your photography, you must learn how to focus correctly. Autofocus or manual focus, the same story, you must learn how to use which one in which situation. So let's talk first about the autofocus. Some of the DSLRs, actually majority of the DSLRs, they have two, three types of autofocus. Mostly they have the continuous focus and they have the single shot autofocus. Now you can set in different modes, you know, even the single shot autofocus and how many focus points do you use, or how wide the focus area is, you know, like the minimal or medium or larger, or there are plenty of settings, but the most important is which type of focus to use in which situation. There are situations where the autofocus is not really a good idea to use, and I will tell you when. But first of all, let's finish the autofocus. So if you want to shoot portraits, then obviously manual focus or autofocus, the single shot autofocus will be completely fine. So that is advisable to use. If you want to track subjects, then you must have your camera set on continuous autofocus. Now in Nikon cameras, you know, there is the 3D tracking. And I would suggest very much to use the 3D tracking. I use myself the 3D tracking, and it is very, very good. It tracks very, very precisely, and I think that it's one of the best tracking systems, you know, at the moment. Obviously, the D5 and probably the D500, they have the same autofocus systems. They are a little bit better than the D7200, but the difference is not very big, so it will be kind of close to each other. Anyway, most important is when you want to track a subject to use continuous autofocus. Now you have to understand that even with the continuous autofocus, sometimes you are in trouble, and I will tell you why. The example, the Sony cameras, the mirrorless cameras, they don't track as well as the DSLRs. And the problem is because they have completely different autofocus system. If you use a DSLR, the tracking will be much better. So if you want to be a sports photographer or something, at the moment on the mirrorless market, I don't know if you can get a mirrorless camera as good as a DSLR. I think that the DSLR is still better than a mirrorless. But you can use mirrorless as well if you want. I have a Sony A6000 at the moment and the Nikon D7200, and I can tell you that the A6000, well, it's not the latest autofocus system, but still it's not as good as the Nikon D7200. Now let's talk a little bit about the manual focus and when in which situation it's advisable to use. I have to tell you that sometimes I found myself in a situation where I wanted to use manual focus because it was easier and much more precise than the autofocus. Sometimes the camera wants to take the control from us and he will focus wherever he wants, you know, I mean the camera will focus wherever he wants, but if you want a precise focus, then it's better to do with manual focus, I would say. Some situations, the example, there are some trees in the front of you and in between the trees there is your subject. Obviously, it's better and much more precise if you use manual focus than if you use the autofocus points. You can try with autofocus as well, but in my experience it will be easier if you use manual focus. I did try the example to shoot some portraits in a forest, and it was very, very nice, you know, but I had to use manual focus because all the trees were close to my subject, and I had to use manual focus to avoid the camera focusing on the trees I wanted to focus in between the trees to my subject. So in these kind of situations, it's advisable to use manual focus. Now, as I told you before, the Nikon D7200's autofocus, it is excellent. It is very good. I will show you in the camera how to set up, you know, the 3D autofocus and how to set up the single shot autofocus. And I will explain to you in the camera's menu how to do it in the best way, in my opinion. If somebody doesn't agree, if somebody has a better idea, please leave a comment down below. I'm just a human, so I can make mistakes as well. And I might learn also. Who knows? We all learn, you know, and at the end of the day, we can always learn from each other. So I will show you in my camera's menu, and you will see the settings, how you set up in a minute. So as you can see, we are in my camera's, in my DSLR's, my Nikon D7200's screen. Sorry, I have to push that to not. Okay, so as you can see down here, you will see the camera is set at the moment at the autofocus continuous. Now, if you want to change that settings, you must push, there is a button in the front of the camera, and I will show you that in a second. So there is this button over here where you can set the manual focus and the autofocus. You see that this button now is at the autofocus position, and also the lens is in the autofocus position. If you want to change it to manual focus, then you have to switch this button to manual focus and to switch this button at the lens at the manual focus. And then you are in completely manual mode. Now, if we are talking about the autofocus, we switch back these both buttons to autofocus position. And then if you see this, the center of this button here, it's an active button, so you can push that. Now, if you push that button and in the same time you turn the front control dial here, you will see that it is switching, you see, it's changing over here, the mode. So this is autofocus continuous. Now it shows it's in 3D tracking mode. This is 51 autofocus points tracking, 21 autofocus point tracking, and 9 autofocus point tracking. And this is a single point tracking. So you can choose whichever you want to use. I use mostly the 3D tracking, and I think that that is the most accurate from all of them. So what I would suggest, if you want to track subjects, put your camera in autofocus continuous mode and 3D tracking. Now again, if you push the same button on the side of the camera, this one, this button, if you push that and you turn the back control dial, this one over here, then you will see that you can change the autofocus auto or autofocus single, the focus mode. The first one, if you turn the front dial, that will be the how you change the autofocus points, how many points you want to use. You see over here how many points you want to use. That's the autofocus area mode. And if you turn the back one, the back dial, then you change the focus mode actually. So this is single shot autofocus. If you change back to continuous autofocus, then you see that you can put in 3D tracking. Now, if you want to use the single shot autofocus in your video mode, it is possible, but then somebody must be behind the camera all the time to adjust the focus. I wouldn't advise that. Now, in video mode, the continuous autofocus in the Nikon D7200 is not as good, is not as responsive as the example in the Sony cameras. I think the Sony cameras, they are a little bit, in video mode, I'm talking about video mode in continuous autofocus. I think that the Sony cameras are a little bit advanced in video mode. They are better. And I will post up here two small videos, so you can see what I'm talking about. Sometimes the Nikon D7200 will will, in video mode, in continuous focus mode, it will hunt, you know, just, I don't know why, I don't understand why it does, but sometimes it just hunts, you know, in continue, and sometimes it locks on, and then in 2 seconds, without any reason, it starts to hunt again, and locks back again. I don't know why is that, but in video mode, the autofocus, in live view mode, the autofocus is not, the tracking is not really good, I would say. The Sony A6000's tracking is much better in regards to the tracking. So I would say, again, to take again and to not to forget. So this is in the back again. There is a switch on the Nikon D7200 now. This is in every camera is different, so it might be different on your camera if you are not using the Nikon D7200. If you take a photo, you have to switch this to the photo mode. If you take a video, then you must. If you do video, you have to switch on video mode. Now, if we go back again, so you push this button over here on the side, and then you a front dial. You will control the area mode, the autofocus area mode, and the back dial you will control autofocus, auto, autofocus, single, and continuous. Now the autofocus auto that is used in photography, not in video. You can actually set to autofocus auto if you are new in photography and you don't really know in which situation, which one you want to choose, the continuous or the single shot. And in autofocus auto mode, the camera will decide if it wants to use the single shot autofocus or the continuous autofocus. If the camera realizes that you try to track something, then it will switch automatically to continuous. If the camera sees that your subject is stationary, then it will use single shot autofocus. So if you are a new photographer, the autofocus auto mode, it's pretty good and it's pretty accurate. I mean, I didn't observe any problem with it. And you can set in the autofocus auto mode, you can set also, you push this button and you set, you know, to 51 points or 21 points or 9 points, and the camera will just track no problem. Or even you can leave it in 3D mode, that's not an issue. So that's what I would suggest. If you are a new photographer, you should use the autofocus auto mode. If you think that you don't forget, and you can remember, then for portraits and for stationary like landscapes and these kind of things, I would use the single shot autofocus without any question. And for tracking, obviously the continuous autofocus. I never used autofocus auto mode, but that's only me. I mean, if you want to use it, that's okay, completely fine, it's good. But if you want to control yourself, then you have to use the autofocus single or continuous, you know, because in auto mode the camera will control when it switches to continuous and when it switches to single. So I hope this video was helpful to you guys, and I hope that somebody will learn from it, and I try to explain as clear as possible, you know, how after my knowledge, how you can set the best way the Nikon D7200. But I'm pretty sorry that I'm talking too fast, but I try to jam, you know, a lot of information in a short video. I don't want to make it long, you know, because it will be long and it will be boring. So I try to jam as much information as possible in a shorter period of time. So I hope that it will be helpful to you, and I hope you will have a nice day, and see you in the next one. Take care, guys.